We are OSU Graphic Design. As a land-grant R1 research institution, OSU is uniquely situated to foster emerging graphic designers who are armed with knowledge, passion, and a view of the design profession in service to society. Our program prepares students to take an influential role in shaping contemporary graphic design practice with a philosophy focused on the action of design, how design transforms, translates, and communicates. The OSU BFA in Graphic Design is a selective four-year professional program with a secondary admission at the end of the foundational freshman year. Classes are sequential, building upon each other to create a holistic sense of the design profession. Graduates are prepared to step into the world with defined personal process approaches grown from an immersion in design thinking and excellent conceptual development. Our first-of-its-kind online minor in graphic design acts as a complement to students studying marketing, business, fine art, or any major that requires creative thinking and visual communication. Delivered through our nationally ranked eCampus program, the minor in graphic design allows students to customize their studies to meet their own goals. At OSU, we believe in developing innovative, independent, critical thinkers and makers ready to take on the changing world of design. Go Beavs!
You get to pick a topic that you're passionate about and that you like.
I remember the first day of class this year, I asked Ian, what is capstone?
And we still don't know what it is.
And then on the flip side, you also get to like learn about the things that your classmates love.
It's been a lot of struggle.
Trial and error, for sure.
Sometimes the best design comes from trial and error.
It's something that you're interested in and want to learn more about. I also think that that is capstone's downfall, is that we've all been studying the same topic for like a year now.
Close with your cohort.
Yeah.
I'll have each other's back, and if we didn't, I don't know if any of us really would have gotten through it.
Yeah. We're all a bunch of cool people.
So. Yo, you think so?
I think you're pretty cool.
You're all right.
I haven't talked to one single person who wasn't like, yeah, I hated my topic at some point in this process. Yeah, so you like love your topic and you hate it, then you love it again, and then you finish your project and you're like, yeah, I did that.
Scratch all the other stuff because our one true piece of advice.
Get a cat.
Get a cat.
Started out as a personal challenge. Last year, we were between two large events involving the United States Postal Service, which was probably the first time that happened, at least in a while. That June, there were concerns that the Postal Service wouldn't make it that much longer due to those in power, and in the following months, some were afraid that mail-in ballots for the election would be too much of a strain on the Postal Service's resources. Deanna told me no one had ever done this sort of project before, so I went for it. To be honest, I didn't really know where the project was going to take me. I did a lot of research about the Postal Service's origins and its history, and as word got out that this is what I was doing, people started giving me resources. Kind of a lot of resources. That's my grandma's stamp collection, for example. By the end, I'd created something incredibly personal. For this project, I wrote and illustrated a short graphic novel featuring a little astronaut cat named Andy and her journey to connect with family on Earth. I didn't want to talk about the pandemic, but it did inspire certain elements of this project. The story takes thematic inspiration from my own efforts to stay connected with my family and how lately I feel a little less alone every time I get a letter, which I'm really grateful for.
Too often, female athletes in leagues are thought of as lesser than their male counterparts. Women's involvement in sports is often the butt of a joke, an afterthought, or the offshoot of the men's version. One of the most recent and blatant examples of the inequality that female athletes face was the 2021 NCAA Division I Women's Basketball Tournament, also known as March Madness, but apparently only for the men's tournament. The different treatment of the tournaments gained national attention when videos posted by U of O's Sedona Prince went viral for showing the differences between the men's tournament and the women's tournament. The differences go beyond facilities and include health and safety measures, swag packages, and even the verbiage and branding that each tournament can use. My goal was to rebrand the women's tournament, to properly celebrate the players, and give them a visual identity that could be recognized and used to hype up the fanfare. The main pieces being a new logo and secondary marks to be used for the Sweet 16, Elite 8, and Final Four. The visual identity I created could be used on a multitude of platforms so that everything in the tournament could feel united and purposeful. From jersey patches and court design to swag bags and social media, I wanted fans and players alike to be able to fully immerse themselves in the tournament. Through my rebrand, I wanted to create assets that fans could use to show their support for the women's tournament. So often the lack of media coverage and marketing hides the fans. The purpose of the rebrand was to represent and celebrate the women's tournament with the same legitimacy and regard as the men's tournament. So what do you say? Let's dance.
Meet Infinite, a brand that uses the economic power of artists and designers to fund the development of sustainable materials and products. Infinite is a platform that creates early career opportunities for artists and supports their development. These opportunities are important because being paid allows artists to spend more time creating and gives them valuable experience. One of our products is sustainable notebooks that come in a variety of styles and materials. Artwork is printed on a cover that can be removed when a notebook is filled and placed on a new notebook. This keeps the inked paper out of the recycling system. Each artist is credited on the inner cover of the notebook, along with the collection information. These storage boxes help keep the notebooks and covers organized and in good condition. This system also works for storing your completed sketchbooks as a collection. Each box can hold up to 15 notebooks and comes designed by an Infinite artist. Or you can get a blank one to create your own. To keep more products out of the landfills, we need to avoid single-use items, even things as simple as pens and markers. This is a disposable pen. You've probably used one of these, and many brands of fine art pens are not refillable. But during the length of this video, over 6,000 pens will be thrown away in the US. By creating products like refillable pens with customizable parts and repairable pieces, we can lengthen the life cycle of the pen. Our goal is to develop new sustainable materials and expand on the uses of existing materials. Giving artists a platform for their work, a fair share of sales, and using their skills to benefit the community is possible with Infinite.
This project promotes mental wellness through free exploration of hobbies, interests, and general wonderments. From nowhere this feeling can come. Like a slow trance, time marches on. Thoughts of hobbies, but you cannot. Explore, you feel only empty. Now imagine a space to go. Wandering curiosities. Paths that show but do not tell you. How to create, merely guiding. A scene of nature surrounds you, reminiscent of open air. A calm, relaxing melody, grounding you, giving you comfort. Colors of possibility, a few suggestions, if needed. For a palette to call your own, to envision your own small world. A song of your beautiful soul, sensitivities, a poem told. Repeating sounds, shared emotions, personal reflections to sing. Cup of sugar, vanilla smell. Associations bake meaning into new tasty memories. A sense of accomplishment here. From nowhere this feeling can come. Like a slow dance, you're swept away. A new hobby enthralls, and yes, there's a place to explore your ponders. Trying new things, a new comfort, it could bring you internal motivation. Here to explore, free to roam, free to wonder. For you, welcome to Wonder Roam. Wonder Roam is a space with the sole purpose of being a welcoming place to learn about, try, and or do activities on one's own or with others in a calm and happy environment. To learn more about Wonder Roam, visit Angelica Ocampo's Wonder Roam Capstone page on the OSU GD website.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the Graphic Design 2021 Hello Blue. My name is Emmett, and I'm going to be your Scoutmaster today. Join me and learn how you can earn your Beaver Scout badge. So, today I'm going to be walking you through how to use this nifty cipher. You're going to be seeing secret messages on the screen throughout the video, and using the cipher to unlock it. Do you not have your cipher with you? Then you can go to this link or use this QR code to download it and print it out. Got it? Okay! So, here's how it works. You're going to be taking the inside rotating piece, find the letter D, and then align it with the outside letter G. Now, your cipher is all set up. You'll be given secret codes throughout the video to put into your cipher to decode the message. You'll want to take the secret letter, put it into the orange piece, and then get the answer by finding its aligned brown piece on the outside. Make sense? Secret message on the inside, answer on the outside. Awesome. We hope you enjoy all of the things that the graphic design seniors have in store for you. Let's go earn those Beaver Scout badges and find out what's all the hullabaloo.
Hey, design nerds. My name is Sydney, I'm from the class of 2018, and I'm here to congratulate you, the class of 2021, on graduating the fabulous OSU Graphic Design program.
Hi! Congratulations, class of 2021. You are done! You should be very proud of all the work that you've created and the future that awaits you.
Congratulations, class of 2021.
Congratulations, graduates from a class of 2012 alumnus.
Hey guys, my name is Alex. I'm graduating class of 2019. Congratulations, seniors. What a great achievement that you've made it to where you are.
Congrats, class of 2021. Yay!
Hi, class of 2021. It's Lexi. Congratulations for making it through college with COVID going on.
Hey, GD class of 2021, Brendan Scott here, former GD student. Would like to congratulate you guys on graduating. It's huge.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Woo woo! This is Alyssa Johnson coming at you from class of 2015.
Hi friends, I'm Kat. I graduated last year in class of 2020, so I have a little bit of a glimpse into what it takes to graduate in a global pandemic, and it's not easy, but you did it. It's all behind you. Take a breath, you deserve it.
Congratulations 2021 GD troops, you did it. You should go celebrate.
Congrats class of 2021. My name's Evan. I was in the design class of 2014.
Congratulations from the class of 1979.
And 2011.
And 2019.
Yay! My piece of advice for you is don't compare yourself to the people around you. Nobody gets from point A to point B exactly the same way, so do it at your own pace.
One, thank your damn professors.
Take some deep breaths and enjoy yourself after you graduate. It's a wild ride for the rest of your life. It's just always going to be that way. So take a little moment to breathe, appreciate what you've been through, acknowledge your own accomplishments.
I would just hold on to this time while you're still like figuring things out, you know? Don't be afraid of having a messy interview somewhere if it's gonna show you how to have a good interview somewhere else.
I bet you're thinking the world is a pretty crazy place right now. And it is, but there's hope, and that's you.
You just never know what you're gonna gain from opportunities that come your way. So as long as you're eager to learn, you're willing to grow your skills, you just ask people for advice. If you work your butt off, things are gonna pay off for you.
Not discount even the smallest opportunity. I took a part-time contract gig at Dave's Killer Bread on a whim. It happened to be a friend of a friend mentioned me to their position. As it turned out, it turned into a full-time position. And now I've been working on the brand for over 6 years, and it's really paved the way for my career.
Remember that you've come from a completely amazing network and group of people, and that outside of school, that doesn't change. So keep those relationships and stay connected.
My advice for graduating seniors is to not worry too much about finding exactly the path you're expecting to, especially in the beginning. Sometimes it's best to just find something that seems cool and then go from there and see kind of what niches you fall into.
Stay that person you're supposed to be, because what's so great about the design world is there's people and teams, agencies, studios, workplaces that will like you for who you are.
Just keep following what makes you weird.
Don't expect your first job to be super glamorous. And if someone else gets a super glamorous job, don't be jealous, because everyone's opportunities come to them when they're supposed to.
And also don't only define yourself by being a graphic designer.
You may be thinking you're done with school, but you will continue to think about your personal brand, website, and a lot of your college projects for years to come.
Accept the praise that people are giving you. I'm not good at that, so I recommend the sooner you learn how to accept praise, the better.
And don't forget to thank your professors. Stay classy, everyone.
Sharing the love and care can start from family, pets, friends, community, and you. Cupid will send your love to someone for support and care. Let us be your Cupid to support various communities. We are donating our profit to charities. Visit our website for more. We will create the products that are just for you. To a card, to a sticker, to a note, and more. 50% of our profit will go to charities for the donation. Here is the way for you to start your order. Please visit our website and select the product that you want. They are two types of products that are package and single item. Cupid line contains our brand, and only product line will contain your individual design. Once you order the product, we will send the confirmation email to you. To add the illustration, send us the photo through the link that are provided in the email. We will design your product by your photo with various version. Once it's done, digital file will send it to your email, and physical products will be sent within 5 to 10 business days. We are looking forward to work with your precious moment. Cupid, deliver the love every moment.
It's a phrase that is often misinterpreted, and I think there's a simple joy in the wordplay it creates. Natural dying. Let's take a journey into the dye pot and die together, because no one wants to die alone. I'm talking about dying fabric. Maybe you'd be surprised at how many people think I'm talking about death, but maybe you are one of them. In any case, I find it very amusing, and more than just being unfortunate wordplay, it demonstrates how far we've come with synthetic dyes. While people have used natural dyes since the beginning of time, synthetic dyes have only been around 165 years and are relatively new to the world. But they're not new to us. For us today, it's hard to imagine a world without synthetic dyes. Environmentally, it's an issue. Textile dyeing causes 17 to 20% of industrial water pollution. And in terms of connection, it's an issue. We see color all around us all the time. In seeing it, we believe that we are connected to it. But getting to create color with our own hands from the plant material around us is indescribable. This is why I created the Dye Pot, a brand that uses dye kits to explore our understanding of color as related to our clothing, textiles, and nature. It spins an ancient art into a modern craft. Understanding our belongings can reduce consumption and create more joy in what we own. Natural imperfect dye has a depth of shades that no chemically made dye could possibly replicate. It transforms the fabric, it becomes alive. The dye is dynamic, and with wear and sun, it will fade and become new all over again. There's a beauty in the impermanence of creation that we no longer recognize. In the words of Keith Recker, an author of a book on natural dying, color is a language we have lost, and one that we must all learn to speak again. Thanks for joining me as I took you through my mordanting and dyeing process. If you want to check out more behind the scenes of the dye pot and my witch's brew box, go to OregonStateGD.com and click Brenna Lanning. I promise you'll like what you see. Cross my heart and hope to die.
Welcome to Little Learners, a resource for learning through fun. With information on Montessori education, free activities, and more, Little Learners is the place for you and your little. We span beyond the screen with physical boxes that deliver to your door. Filled with age-specific activities, tips and tricks, and quality toys, the boxes for your little contain hours of learning. Simply go to our website, select the age of your little, and place an order. The Little Learner boxes grow with your child, with activities of increasing difficulty and engagement specifically designed to encourage your little in creativity, independence, and confidence. Play with your little and join the community. Little Learners, open for fun.
Unexplainable wonders that come together ever so perfectly to create this planet that we call home. This is what the Obsidian Project will explore, the meeting point between these fantastical forces. Individualizing post-consumer waste to bring out your inner nomad. Admiring the sleek figure of the stone, we look to minimalism. Cherishing its polished finish, we strive for sustainability. Embodying its transparency, we make sure you know exactly what you're getting and where it came from. Year after year, over 1.5 trillion gallons of water is wasted developing new textiles. Year after year, 26 billion pounds of reusable textiles are thrown away. The Obsidian Project is all scrap. The collection is not just locally sourced, but made from 100% scrap materials. And we use 100% of those scraps. We work with an expert seamstress in order to ensure that every inch of fabric is taken into account, with no scrap left behind. Our dedication to the reduction of resources and the implementation of scrap materials allows for each piece to be not just 100% unique, but also a step forward. Because we're tired of all this scrap.
Welcome to Campfire, a podcast produced by the Oregon State University Graphic Design Program.
In this series of podcasts, we are speaking with the students about their lives and the experiences that have shaped them into the people they are today. I think the most inspiring thing for me is the outdoors, and I actually have a huge passion for photography that I have kind of purposefully never really done academics around. It's sort of like my safe space. It's like my creative space for nobody to tell me that this is like the right or wrong way to photograph this, or like that this is, you know, it sort of like refreshes me from everything else because there are no rules. Like, I'm photographing what I'm seeing, my experiences of it, my perspective, where I'm going, and definitely like the outdoors recharges me, so I combine both of those a lot.
Yeah, I think that nature and being out in it is a big inspiration for me too. It really is a refreshing change from being stuck to your computer all the time. And it's so easy for us to just be on a screen almost 24/7.
Photography also encourages me to go outside even more than I already do. And so it's sort of like a really healthy habit in a way that it inspires me creatively, but it also just refreshes my body. So I feel like it's not only helping keep my creative spirit alive, but helping keep me healthier as a designer and healthy enough to like continue doing the other work that I both love doing and that's more challenging to me.
Welcome to my capstone project, Sprout, and today we're going to be talking about houseplants. For my project, I was really interested in how houseplants affect our emotions and feelings. During the interviews with plant owners, I got overwhelmingly positive responses. People said they felt stress relief, relaxation, joy, and happiness. For other people, caring for houseplants made them feel less suicidal. I was really excited to hear people talk so passionately about how plants made them feel, and I wanted to find a way to incorporate that into my own project. I explored a lot of different ways that I could achieve this, that I could bring these emotions out from my audience, and ultimately what I came up with was video games. I didn't have any experience making video games, but I had experience playing them, and I knew that they had a very powerful way of changing our moods, altering our emotions, and so I thought that would be the perfect route to take my capstone project. Sprout is a simple platform game that aims to bring joy to the user and emulate all those positive feelings that houseplants bring owners across the world.
Have you ever considered the secret world around us? Letters from the Insect World is a collection of 18 essays or letters that tell the life histories of different insects from their own point of view. The aim is to capture young readers' interest and give the stories a lighthearted twist while being informative about a variety of amazing insects, some familiar and others less well known. Letters from the Insect World started as a single story, Musings of a Mayfly, and expanded to a writing project to keep Margaret occupied during quarantine. My grandmother started sharing these short stories with her writers group and family. When I read these magical little tales, I was fascinated. I've had an interest in publication and was really excited to have so much material to work with. When I first brought up the idea last summer that I could illustrate and design this, at the time unnamed, collection of letters as my senior capstone project, my gran was also extremely excited. The bulk of this project was illustration and watercolor, as well as designing and laying out the book. Over the last few months, I've painted more insects than I ever considered that I would in my life. I laid out and designed the full text and built a brand system and ad campaign around it. Together, we also created a book prospectus, and eventually we'd love to see it in stores and libraries. Letters from the Insect World is geared towards upper elementary and middle school education by delivering factual information in a narrative format.
although in my humble yet biased opinion, it's a great read for any age. I wanted to aim for a realistic yet whimsical delivery for the imagery in the book, since that's how I began to interpret this aspect of nature. A huge shout out to my grand Margaret for the gift of her words, cooperation, and full freedom on this project, and I'm thrilled for us to see it fully realized. Visit my capstone on the OSU GD site to read a few of these insect stories, and remember, we share our world with numerous fascinating creatures, with miracles in their life we can't always completely understand.
This is Adoptees Amplified. Every year on May 22nd, my parents give me a card with flowers or a gift, not because it's my birthday or a holiday, but because it's the anniversary of the day that we became a family. I was adopted from South Korea 23 years ago by my two amazing parents. Adoption is something that I feel like not a lot of people talk about or know much about, and for me being an adoptee, it can be kind of awkward to talk about sometimes. I get asked questions like, what's it like to be adopted? Do you know your real parents? And questions like that are never really easy for me to answer or process even. I think most people approach adoptees with kind of this sense of either sympathy or really pointed questions like that. I had a great childhood, but growing up as an Asian American girl raised in a white household definitely presented some challenges for me regarding my identity. I feel like I've spent most of my life trying to navigate that and figure out my cultural belonging and identity. Even now, I feel like I still have a lot more to learn and discover. Whenever I meet other Asian American adoptees, especially women, I feel a really unique and special connection to them that I think comes from shared experiences and perspectives. For my capstone project, I wanted to share some of that and explore the topic of adoption by creating something that both empowers adoptees and educates non-adoptees. I think that the best way to educate is to tell your story to people who are really listening. So this is Adoptees Amplified, and it's a zine that aims to do just that. So I had six amazing Asian American women adoptees who participated in this project along with myself, who all shared their stories and just anything else that they want people to know about adoption, about their experience. I illustrated all of us in a style that represents the idea of overlap, which communicates the place where both cultures and families come together. I'm really excited for people to read this zine and to experience this project that I've put so much of myself in. If you'd like to read this zine in a digital format, you can find it on my capstone page on the OSU GD website.
I live in Philomath, so I'm like 3 minutes away from Corvallis, so I don't really miss anything. I'm there all the time.
So I actually haven't left Corvallis, but I think what I miss most about OSU and being in school is probably what a lot of you guys are missing, of just being in class together, working together, collaborating together, super fun. I think also just the amount of time that you have to devote to projects that you don't necessarily get in a job in the same way.
McMinimins and happy hours with our professors and cohort, the best parts of college. So soak it up and congratulations again.
This might be partially because I've been craving going out after being in lockdown for the last year, but I think what I miss most about Corvallis is going to the Peacock. There were many fun nights had at the top of the Peacock, drinking AMFs. Don't remember a lot of it.
I think definitely the farmer's market and the food and just all the produce and the flowers.
The thing that I miss most about Corvallis is the community and how accessible everything was. You know, I could go out to coffee with my mentors. I could go down the hallway and say, you're a designer, I'm a designer, let's be friends. It's not so easy right when you get out of school.
My favorite thing about Corvallis was probably 88.7 FM at KBVR Corvallis, where I spent much of my time for doing my show, The Kitchen Sink, for all 4 years. Many a late night up at the station. You could say that KBVR was my favorite camping spot as well. For legal reasons, that is a joke.
People and the college atmosphere of, and I'm like, not just like the craziness, but just, you know, the idea like you're rushing towards all of these like random projects with your friends and your cohort and just making it work and being super creative. And I think I do miss that. I've like, you get it in your job, but it's different. Like things are on the line. So, and the relationships you build from all that is just amazing.
One thing I will definitely miss the most about campus is doing my graphic design work in Bings and getting all the information about the drama and sororities and fraternities. And they had the best tea. And I would invite my friends, like anyone from the cohort, to come sit with me.
Senior design cohort. I mean, we've been with each other almost every single school day for the past 4 years. We've seen each other grow as designers and even as people. I mean, we're basically like a small family.
The people, I really liked getting to know new people and making new friends and getting to know others from different backgrounds with different interests and hobbies and majors.
As cliche as it may sound, I'm gonna miss all the people. I think it's such a treat that we got to spend 3 years together figuring out graphic design for the first time. And I'm going to miss being in a stage of life where I'm surrounded by people embarking on the same thing at the same season of life with me. And I've enjoyed every minute of it.
What I'm gonna miss the most was basically the atmosphere and the environment. I used to hang out in the hallways while waiting for class, and a lot of my classmates would come by and be like, hi, Kylie. And you know, I'm really gonna miss like my friends.
Because our school is so small, we get to know our professors and our classmates a lot. And I think that is like a really unique thing that not a lot of people get to do. Okay, take note of all of June's amazing outfits, like a style icon, literally every time that he walks through the door. I love Rick's like little things that we all know him for. He uses the word garish a lot. Oh, his son, who I still don't know the name of. And Christine's love for like Cupid Mayo. Yeah, I don't know what that's about. All of her beautiful slide decks that are very aesthetic. And of course, Deanne, like a freaking powerhouse, very encouraging, love her. Just like, I don't know, I'll miss that.
I'm gonna miss Rick asking us kindly to do anything. Just kindly pulling up Illustrator or kindly grabbing our X-Acto knives.
I would definitely have to say North Porch Cafe, because every time I would have an exam, I would treat myself to curry and Thai iced tea.
Being able to talk to your classmates just in class and ask questions about assignments, and also being able to talk to your professors face to face, because going to office hours over Zoom is just not as personal as it is when it's in person.
Food.
Okay, that's not true. I will miss Taco Vino. I'm a little obsessed with their potatoes, and I always force people to try them because they're so good. God, they're so good.
Design creates a visual way for the listener to interpret an artist. For my research, two main factors of a successful album stood out: the CD as a collector's item and a cohesive narrative throughout. I found the artist Ige and used his existing body of work for my album design, with music that explores melancholy, love, and loss. The concept of the album revolves around a lonely astronaut, with these songs being the entries in his journal as he searches for belonging. To create a collector's piece out of the album, it also includes photo cards, a rocket cutout to assemble, and a sticker sheet. Then, the merch combines the design styles of both the album and the music video, tying the narrative together. Finally, the last piece of the project was an animated music video for the album's first single, The Other Side.
Do you ever think about me? All 'cause you're probably busy. Me too can count the blessing. There have been too many lately. All day been smiling lately. Turkey, just bought a boy, here's a big three. And man, if my jeans are thick, sometimes I think about you, even in the midst of good news. I gotta go home, pull out all the old balls from the closet, and then I see you. Yeah, you're so cheesy. My God, it's messing with my head, 'cause you took mine. Sometimes I just call, I know you won't pick up. Can't ever help myself and try. Scared, just get alone. So every night I hope I see you on the other side. Cool.
fashion production and consumption has reached unsustainable levels, drastically affecting our environment. While we have more items in our wardrobes, we're wearing what we have less often and throwing out our clothes too quickly, keeping clothing for almost half as long as we did 15 years ago. Clothing can be recycled, reused, resold, or repurposed. Second Life focuses on that simple principle. The goal of Second Life is to raise awareness and speak to our shared responsibility on the environmental impacts of apparel production and consumption. Screen printing on clothes has allowed my creativity to be expressed onto my garments. Second Life is about experimenting with the process until we know it feels right. Clothes should be designed to be creative with purpose and ingenuity.
Why did he do that? It undermines the credibility of the entire White House press office
Don't be so overly dramatic about it, Chuck. You're saying it's a falsehood, and they're giving Sean Spicer, our press secretary, gave alternative facts to that. But the point remains.
Wait a minute. Alternative facts?
With the rise of social media in the last decade, combined with the cutthroat tactics politicians have used for nearly a century, we as voters are faced with a broad set of unique challenges when navigating the tumultuous political waters.
Have you been watching television?
We are fighting Satan himself.
Watch television. See what people are saying.
Logical fallacies, fake news, conspiracy theories, and alternative facts have become the new normal.
People said, Trump is crazy.
That is patently false.
You don't know what you're talking about, idiot.
Will you shut up, man?
Enter the alternative fact scene, a voter's guide to common logical fallacies used in political discourse. Inspired by the punk and riot girl zine culture of the 80s and 90s, Alternative Facts is designed to be easily accessible and reproducible, allowing anyone who wishes to inspire voters to do their own research and make decisions at the polls based on their own informed opinions, and not just listen to what some talking head tells them to believe. Remember, be critical of anything and everything a politician says. They aren't your friend, they're elected by you to do one job only, and that's represent the will of the people who put them into office. We have the power to change the course of history. All we need to do is make our voices heard, do our own research, and wage war on alternative facts.
camping anywhere where there's water nearby. So I like going to the beach, camping near lakes. Spruce Run up in the northern coast is beautiful. Love that. Now I'm more of an Airbnb or like a hotel kind of vacation person. I'm a borderline elder at this point, and I don't want to sleep on a hard ground anymore.
I'm going to go with weirdest because the best sadly got burned up last year. Weirdest camping spot was an abandoned campground from the 60s on some island that we had to backpack 2 days for. There was like old food in these like really old lockers and like porta potties from the 60s. It was bonkers.
My favorite camping spot is probably Willawa Lake. It's gorgeous and the mountains are huge.
My favorite place to go camping is somewhere that I used to go all the time with my dad and my siblings. It's in Port Orford, which is in southern Oregon. It's called Black Rock. It's a 6 mile hike up a cliff, and at the top of the cliff, there's just miles and miles of ocean, and there's forest behind you, and it really is the most peaceful place on earth.
So one of my favorite hikes in Corvallis, which I'm sure a lot of people have gone to, is Bald Hill, because it's really easy and simple, and I did all of these photography projects there. Riley Wolf and I did a project, and we lit some sage to burn, and we were worried about burning down the forest, but it turned out okay, so.
I'll go with the two most underrated spots that I don't hear a lot about in Corvallis, but are definitely some of my favorite is Bazile Forest and Finley Wildlife Refuge.
I think one of my favorite outdoor activities around Corvallis would have to be Mary's Peak. I grew up in a car family, and that is one of the most beautiful drives in Oregon, those curvy hills up to the top, and then walking around and seeing all the gorgeous views.
Favorite camping spot has got to be Jedediah Smith River in the Redwoods.
Mary's Peak, and I remember the last time that I went there, there was a guy playing the bagpipes on a hill, and it was pretty majestic.
When in high school, my family took me camping for the second time for my birthday, and we all gathered around the campfire and told spooky, scary stories that we made up on the spot, underneath the starry sky at night and surrounded by forests.
Well, I really love the Sulphur Springs area, and one of my favorite trails there, I believe it's called Spider Peak, but basically you exit the forest and crest over this hill to this flat area of wildflowers with a sheer drop off one side. And I remember this run where it was just full of fog, and it's really an ethereal area.
I would have to say, hands down, that would be Waldo Lake. It's absolutely beautiful. There's sparkling water. Just be warned, you're gonna be battling mosquitoes the whole time you're there.
Hey there, my name's Darby, that's me frolicking, and that's my pal Bob. But more importantly, this is a story of how my love for plant-based cooking and my obsession with the planet inspired my Capstone project. My project, Food for Thought, is centered around destigmatizing plant-based eating and breaking down the barriers of perfection that often surrounds environmental consciousness. Our busy lives often make it difficult to slow down and smell the roses, but when we get the chance to take a look at the world around us, it bursts with life. From animals and plants, big and small, our planet's ecosystems are spectacular, but unfortunately, they are not miracle workers. One of the largest climate stressors is agriculture, which alone makes up 30% of the world's greenhouse gas emissions. American emissions could be reduced by thousands of tons if every American ate plant-based for just one day a week. Making conscious effort towards sustainability means a future Earth with more smiles, tree hugs, spectacular views, and rad photos. It is my belief that fear does not foster learning. However, facts and digestible information do. Food for Thought, Plant-Based Cooking Guide, does just that. Sections on progress over perfection, sourcing the right ingredients, and knowing the truth behind food labels are just a few of the guides provided to help make sustainable choices attainable. A full recipe section of plant-based alternatives for popular meat and dairy products also aids in an easy introduction to plant-based cooking. To leave you with a little food for thought, always remember that small acts, when multiplied by millions, will transform the world. Thank you. We'll be right back.
My name is Kylie, and my capstone project is called Spellbound. Spellbound is a gothic alternative clothing line designed for those who want to be unique with a dark edge. This project includes hand-sewn and hand-designed clothing, a gallery of modeled photos as well as product photos, and a website mock-up. Overall, this project includes gothic elements with a pop of fun feminine flair and a bold twist. Let's go check out the process. Well, it started out with a lot of sketching and ideation, then a lot of sewing, then we got to the creation, design, and implement of the designs onto the clothing. Once those were all ready, it was time for the photo shoot. After a lot of hard work editing images, it was finally time to begin the website build, which would be the last big piece for this project. So what's the final result? Well, here it is. Thank you for watching, and I hope you loved it as much as I did making it.
Hi there, I'm Jamie, and my project is on character design. When the prompt, "What do you want to learn about?" came up for Capstone, I immediately went with character design, since I've always wanted to learn how to draw them. I first started with a character brief and wrote a bit about the world and setting that the character was in to get to know the character and get an idea for what he would look like. My first two deliverables were a map and a storyboarded comic to go along with the character brief. Writing isn't my strong suit, so it was nice to start drawing a little. Next, I drew some poses on a grid to make sure the proportions were correct and to use them as a guide for the rough drafts. Everything after this is my process leading up to the final concept. I did 3 rough drafts before choosing one to refine, and from there, I got to work on drawing him in various poses, along with spreading out all of the gear on my character. I'm really proud of how far I've come in a relatively short amount of time, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I did making it.
Pulling out the coupe at the lot, turn the 12 SWAT, buzzing all the bells out the box. I just hit a lick with the box, had to put the stick in the box. Pour up the whole field, I'ma get lazy. I got the mojo deals, we been trapping like the 80s. So, got the cash out, told them wipe it. No, say slash slash. I won't never sell my soul, and I can back that. And I really wanna know where you at. I was at back, where the stash at? Cruise the city in a bulletproof Cadillac. Cause I know these out there where the bag at. Gotta move smarter, gotta move
harder. Try to give me 5 mile water. I lay it down on my son, on my daughter. I had the Draco with me, Dwayne Carter. Lot of n***s out here playing, ain't ballin'. I done put my whole arm in the rim, Vince Carter. And I know Poppy get a key for the portal. Shawty barely seen the double C's, I bought her. Got a guy that's looking like a Leo, she a model. I got the pink slip. My whip is keyless. Compton, I'm about to get the key to the city. Patty, light up the seat. Forgetting out the coupe at the lot. Tony, 12, SWAT. Buzzing all the bells out the box. I just hit a link with the box. Had to put the stick in the box. Pour up the whole seal. I'ma get lazy. I got the mojo deals. We been trapping like the 80s. So, got the cash out. Tony, I'm wiping. No, say slash. Won't never sell my soul, and I can back that. And I really wanna know.
Aesthetic, a branch of philosophy that deals with the nature of beauty and taste, as well as the philosophy of art. There's a long list of variables that can influence an aesthetic, but there are three in particular that catch my attention. Fashion, lifestyle, and color. Let's circle color for later. Aesthetics often have defining group names like punk, grunge, goth, cottagecore, dark academia, light academia, blah blah blah, and the list goes on and on and on. However, aesthetic is a very human experience, one that is rooted in individuality and personal preferences. Some people experience aesthetics even if it doesn't pertain to every single part of their lifestyle. Like how I am deeply fascinated by the skater aesthetic, and yet I can't for the life of me ride a skateboard. I try though. That's why something I always liked about exploring these groups was to see what colors in particular brought them to life. For my project, I wanted to connect color and its influence on fashion and lifestyle within the realm of aesthetics. What colors become a staple to one? How can the mood of a color influence our personal visual preferences? So, let me introduce you to Room Hues, a point-and-click side-scroller that also works as a personalized color generator. The premise is simple. Go and click on different sections of the room. Select an object that fits closest to your own personal preference. And when you're finished, the game will generate a color scheme for you depending on what items you selected. The game directly reflects your personal aesthetic and colors your world in a way that can only be described as you. You might be thinking, well, I don't define myself to just one aesthetic over the others. And I say, that's no problem. Room Hues has a total of 30 unique options to choose from. So whether your style is casual or hardcore, there is an option for everyone. And everyone deserves to color their world in their own way. What will your colors be?
I can't look at myself in a camera. One thing that TikTok did for me in 2020 was diagnose me with pretty severe ADHD. So I've realized that I really can't make eye contact with myself or on the camera. And I look, yeah. Sorry.
I've had a lot of Zoom calls during quarantine. Our company almost always has us have our video on, so not many opportunities to hide what we're doing or what we're wearing.
I'd say on. I did video off for an entire year. Never saw two people I worked with for an entire year, and that was strange as hell.
I'm definitely a Zoom video on person.
Oh, I am totally an on-camera Zoomer. It seems to be my only chance these days to have face-to-face interactions, and I need human contact or I will go crazy.
I am a video on Zoomer. I feel really awkward having my camera off, so I prefer to just keep the camera on, but I always make sure to try to keep the background looking really nice. So I'll do some pre-cleaning and look at the camera space and see like what's behind me so I can try to make it look cute.
I'm definitely an on-zoomer. I feel like if I'm gonna be on there, might as well show my face.
I am video on for work because we're required to, a little old-fashioned. Here's a tip for you. So like you can see, this is my office space. I'm working from home permanently now.
So I've got like this little office set up, very chaos. So I usually am on video with the background blur, but if you need a more business location, I have kept one wall very business.
I'm a mix between video on, video off. If I'm at my desk number one, video on. But most of the time, I'm at desk number two, which is my bed.
When it comes to Zoom in the camera feature, I definitely try to keep my camera on as much as possible. Some days it could be a little hard to do that, but I always like seeing people's faces, and so I try to keep my camera on as well.
That definitely depends on the situation and the vibe of the Zoom. If a bunch of other people have it on, I'll probably join. But if I have it on, I'll also probably be looking at my square for most of the Zoom.
I wish I was a camera on type of person. I wish I had that confidence to like always have my face showing, but 8 a.m.'s are rough.
It depends. I would say mostly off because I'm in bed, but if I actually like look good that day, then you know that video was on.
So I thought about this one a little bit. I was like, Stefan Sagmeister, I think we would end up killing each other. I love his work, but like, I can't. I decided I think it might be David Carson. I'm pretty sure he would be able to keep us alive. I think he knows how to start a fire. I know that he's good at surfing and he's an outdoorsy person. So I feel like he'd be able to keep us alive. And I can fish, so like, if we were near water, would we be okay?
Hopefully it's Vignelli, because he's good with maps.
So if I had to pick some designers that I wanted to go camping with, I would have to pick three because I can't pick just one. Jessica Hish, for sure. Also Debbie Millman, because I can listen to that woman talk for hours. And James Victori, because somebody's got to bring the whiskey.
If I ever got stranded while I was camping, I would 100% bring Deanne with me. She bikes, she swims, and I am totally confident that she could help me get out of that situation.
I think it would be really interesting to be stranded while camping with Annie Adkins, because I'd love to see what she could create with the materials at hand.
If I were stranded with any designer, it would be Bianca, because she's my girl. And also, like, we could live out our Animal Crossing fantasies together. We'd probably die, but you know.
Hi, my name is Hannah, and for my capstone project, I chose to focus on the presence of accessibility in public spaces. I want to inform people outside of the disabled community what accessibility is to open up a conversation on ways to help enforce ADA restrictions to improve accessibility standards in our own communities. To communicate these ideas, I created a video and tools that would help explain ways everyone can consider accessibility in their own daily lives to encourage more people to enforce ADA restrictions and help make every space inclusive. At least 1 billion people worldwide live with disabilities, yet not every area is accessible. The more people who consider accessibility, the more government officials and business owners will recognize it is essential to their citizens and customers and begin to ensure it is incorporated in more spaces. Now let's have a quick lesson on what accessibility is. When most people think of accessibility, they think of a closed parking space, an elevator, or automated doors. However, accessibility is any tools that improve the quality of being reached or entered. So, tools such as handrails, flat pathways, L door handles, and open spaces are simple solutions to help improve accessibility in public spaces. Now, to find out what more you can do in your own daily life to improve accessibility, you can navigate to the Capstone Show webpage and click on Hannah Phillips to explore my project. There, you will find an informational video and important diagrams and posters to help guide you on the road of considering accessibility so that together we can create a more inclusive world.
One of the most significant changes in the automotive industry is that the car interface is increasingly important for competitive product development. The users are going to purchase not only a physical product itself, but also services. So product experiences expand in both physical and digital forms. For the Capstone project, I work on UX UI design for a car interface of electric cars and came up with ICOS. ICOS is the intelligent car operating system that increases usability with visualization and new functionalities. ICOS has two separate main screens. The left screen provides essential information for a driver about a car and driving mode settings that support drivers. The right screen has media functions such as maps, browsers, and entertainment for both drivers and passengers. The contrasting colors, 3D looking buttons, and multiple screens provide a better user experience due to the visual hierarchy and responsiveness to the changes depending on driving status. ICOS allows the users to connect to mobile devices. One for the car media so the users can enjoy the music from the passenger's phone. And the other one for hands-free audio so the driver can answer a phone call during driving. The driver will have an alert that is distinguished by the fonts and colors to understand information quickly. ICOS alerts with green, yellow, and red depending on how dangerous the situation is. For more information about ICOS, please scan the QR code or click the link in the group chat to visit the ICOS homepage.
Full transparency, Different was built on a problem that I saw right in my own closet. In a recent study of 1,000 US individuals, the average consumer had 103 items of clothing in their closet. While conducting my own survey, I also found that nearly every person claimed white and black as two of their most worn colors. By looking at my own closet first and understanding that I was not alone, I was able to address an issue of excessive amounts of similar garments in people's closets. I chose to find a solution that would reduce fabric in people's closets without compromising creative expression. My end product takes high-quality blank t-shirts and gives the consumer the ability to interchange graphics on them. These tees from Ecolife are a beautiful blend of organic and recycled cotton that maximizes comfort and allows for multiple wears per wash. They are also created using highly circular production techniques. Consumers may bring in their old clothing and have them cut and sewn to a reduced size. With the addition of recycled buttons on different tees, consumers can keep the designs they love and express themselves through while reducing the amount of fabric in their closet. Excess fabric will be recycled back into production, repurposed back into new items such as totes, or relocated to companies better suited to use the material. It really all depends on the shape that the initial garment was in. While it's important to creatively express yourself through clothing, it's also important to lower your effects on the earth while doing so. With Different, you can achieve both simultaneously.
Emma Petit, and my capstone project is called Cosmic Crunch. Cosmic Crunch is an empowering, bold, and delicious space-themed cereal brand on a mission to empower young kids. It offers three tasty flavors, Star Puffs, Astros, and Meteor Bites. Enjoying a bowl of cereal while reading the back of the box is a core memory for most people's childhood. That is why the Cosmic Bunch, Ella, Andy, and Trix are here to help kids have a blast while blasting off from the narrative of traditional male mascots seen on most cereal boxes. Their hope is to strengthen and encourage kids to find their own superpowers. The back of each box offers out-of-this-world games. So be sure to grab something to write with for the solar system crossword puzzle or for the tricky space maze. Also, be ready to feel inspired when reading about the powerful women who have made significant contributions to space travel and research, just like you could, located on the side of each cereal box. It is the Cosmic Crunch mission for this delicious cereal brand to help fuel the impact that you're making in this world and encourage you to become anything you aspire to be in the voyage of your discovery. Love, Cosmic Crunch. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Riley DeFeo. My capstone project is a comic book centered around Micah, a college freshman with autism spectrum disorder. The story is about Carmen and Micah, two friends who navigate their first semester of college together. They have two completely separate majors, so the only way they can really see each other is by enrolling in class together. The only problem is Micah's professor doesn't really accommodate his needs. And read the short story to find out what happens next. Micah's an introvert, but he talks a lot when he's nervous or when he's passionate about something or when he's really comfortable around other people. Also, I just really like the alliteration. They first met in high school after Carmen transferred to Micah's school. Micah was super friendly to Carmen, so they just kind of stuck together after that. I would like people to know that I'm not trying to generalize autism spectrum disorder through this tiny little comic book. You know, it is in fact a spectrum and everyone's different. I do want to point out that media representation, although it's gotten better, is definitely skewed a certain way and more often than not performed by people who aren't on the spectrum. And I just want autism to be destigmatized and well represented. Making a comic book is super hard. Appreciate your comic book and manga artists.
Collecting supplies to start hobbies with. That's my favorite hobby. I like to buy things and then never do it. So I've got like tie-dye kits. I've got resin art kits. You wouldn't like the amount of craft supplies that I have in my house are absolutely insane. But really the only hobby that I've become very proficient in is TikTok. I don't post, I consume.
My favorite hobby in the last year is probably I picked up journaling again, and I really recommend it for anybody who likes to write, or even if you don't particularly like to write. Journaling, just like a one line a day journal, is just a nice way to chronicle your days.
A hobby that I picked up during quarantine is kickboxing. It's great exercise and great stress relief, and I highly recommend if you don't have an outlet for your stress that you find one. Maybe it's kickboxing.
I think like a lot of people, I've found myself a little bit more free time in the past year of just revisiting things that I enjoy, skateboarding and playing guitar, which has been a lot of fun. And I think they're both creative in a lot of ways. And so it's fun to have a sort of creative outlet outside of graphic design.
Is getting back into video games. And I'm not good at video games, but I do enjoy playing them. And it turned into me starting the stream.
Writing. I love storytelling and being able to take the stories that I've had in my head and finally have the time to write them down and practice with how I want to present my stories to the world was really fulfilling.
Definitely decorating my planner. This style of decorating with stickers. My favorite way to decorate my planner is definitely with my own illustrations.
This isn't like a new hobby, but I've recently picked it back up and I've been super into rock climbing since the new gym opened up around here.
Screen printing. I've always wanted to like do more screen printing, and I always said if I had the time, I would.
and we all had a lot of time on our hands this past year.
Making more street art, or just like taking different designs and like making stickers out of them, tagging them around town, putting them on pots, things of that nature.
One of my favorite hobbies that I've picked up in the last year has got to be crocheting. I've made a lot of hats, but the biggest project that I took on was making a sweater vest, and it's probably my favorite project that I've done so far.
Hi, I'm Miranda Dewey, and my Capstone project is focused on the traveling experience of people who are blind or visually impaired. During this project, I looked for problem areas in airports and why navigating in them can be so confusing at times. I envisioned a space that isn't just a pass-through from one place to the next, but rather a space that's enjoyable and exciting for everyone. My designs were a set of changes that could be made to the Portland International Airport for more effortless navigation and an overall elevated experience. The importance of a signage system is essential in a successful space or environment, and I viewed these spaces as a network of people constantly moving. I wanted to step away from the visual pollution and put forth content that actually matters. People who are blind and visually impaired rely on other sensory aspects, which are often overlooked in architectural design. My designs enhance sensory experiences for an efficient way of travel. Through this project, I hope to show more than just visual aesthetics, and that design can be communicative in all forms. If you would like to learn more about my project, click on my name, Miranda Dewey, on the Oregon State GD website or the link I'll be sharing with you all.
Colorbox, a monthly subscription to a world of color. Do you ever feel like your day is dull and boring? What do you do when you find yourself seeing the same colors every day and can't seem to catch sight of anything fun or new? Make the most out of what you already have in the world around you with Colorbox. A Colorbox subscription is the ultimate color guide. It not only encourages emotional and physical connections to the world around you, but provides the resources and tools on how to dress or decorate to influence your everyday mood. Colorbox is there to offer you greater knowledge and understanding about a new color every month. Receive a detailed guide about the month's color as you begin finding every color everywhere. In addition to our jam-packed color guide, Colorbox is fun-filled with things to wear, something to share, a colored light to decorate, stickers, and a coloring book, along with coloring utensils in hues of that month's color. Wondering what happens after a rainbow of boxes? Like the rainbow, Colorbox never ends. Stick around to collect an everlasting universe of color. Each month will surprise you with new handmade products made by a collection of artists. Colorbox, connect with the world around you.
Thank you.
The definition of nutrition is the process of providing and obtaining the food necessary for health and growth.
Fewer than 1 in 10 adults and adolescents eat enough fruits and vegetables.
Choose Nutrition helps you navigate the grocery store easily and quickly. It supplies you with paper that show examples of carbohydrates, fats, and proteins, and also items that are high in essential vitamins. The other paper represents how much of each section you should be buying. It also shows the stickers that are on certain items and what they represent that you can find throughout the store. If you want to dive deeper into what nutrition you and your family should have in your life, then download our app to learn more.
Don't wear regular clothes anymore. We've decided that all of our wardrobes in our house are split into soft pants and hard pants. I only wear soft pants. I don't wear hard pants anymore. And I really never leave my house.
The looking nice up top and then having pajamas below until you like wake up at 6 in the morning and you think something that was a conference call actually was a Zoom call. So then you might rush and put on a shirt and call it good.
I was super good with not buying takeout for a good year, and it wasn't until like 2 or 3 months ago that I started ordering 2 large pizzas from Domino's, probably every other week.
And a mix of 4 p.m. happy hour and reality TV. 90 Day Fiancé.
The worst habit I've picked up in the last year is buying antique clothing on Etsy. They're really pretty, really delicate, and really expensive.
So I think the worst habit that I picked up during quarantine is plants, just because it's so addictive. Like, I can't stop.
Ever since COVID happened, the idea of a healthy sleeping schedule has been lost on me. Am I gonna go to bed early or late? Am I gonna wake up early or late? I don't know.
Well, that would have to be my sleep schedule. It's never been great, but it took some extra hits between naps and a less steady schedule this year.
Definitely been wearing exercise pants a lot more. I rarely wear jeans anymore, but honestly, I recommend it.
Doing work and homework from my bed.
It's Taco Bell. I never ate Taco Bell before COVID. Like, probably in at least like 3 years.
So this one involves my roommate. We sometimes will take her mattress from her room and put it in the living room and build a nest and sleep there for a minimum of one night. And we get Taco Bell.
Introducing my capstone project, which is a DIY natural dye kit. The cochineal dye, which carries a flare of vibrant coloration, has been used for centuries and continues to be used today in modern times. This is one of many natural resources used for dyeing today. The content within my box include the following: 58 inches of silk, wool, and cotton fabric, 1 pair of gloves, 1 bottle of ground and jaggered cochineal, 5 wooden spoons, 1 pamphlet, and 2 cochineal stickers. As you get started, you'll want to do the following. Dissolve the extract in a small amount of cool water. Stir the extract well till all the particles dissolve. Add your pre-mordanted fabric into the pot and be sure there is enough water to cover the fabric completely. Bring the pot to heat at 200 degrees Fahrenheit for wool, 190 for cotton, and 185 for silk. Process may take between 30 to 60 minutes. Once your fabric has been heated in the pot, leave the fabric to absorb dye overnight. Remove your fabric the next morning and rinse it under cold water. The coloration within the fabric may vary between the amount of extract and the type of fabric you use. Be sure to have fun, and thank you for watching.
Hello, my name is Lily. Thank you so much for watching. Let's get right into my capstone project. The concept of my project was born out of me always crafting and finding new hobbies. LH Studios is a small business owned by me. It was created as an online space used to curate crafts and goods that I make and sell, eventually with other designers and artists as well. These goods are mostly artwork to decorate your home or fashion accessories. For the sake of the scope of this project, we are focusing on clay earrings. Made out of palm or clay, these earrings are for the minimalist individual who still wants to make a statement with their outfits. The best part is 15% of the proceeds go towards art programs at local schools to keep creativity alive. The colors for LH Studios branding were inspired by the New Mexican landscape, where I currently live. The logo was inspired by mid-century modern design. The packaging has a handmade look with the logo stamped on top. Each pair of earrings are packed with an earring card as well as a business card.
That's why we believe, no matter who you are, or how old you are, everyone has the right to express themselves. At Laval, we believe that we all deserve to feel like you can be yourself.
Check out our website, where you can find a variety of products in numerous shades and colors.
Our products are perfect for experimenting with your style. Everyone should be able to use makeup, no matter your background, race, or gender. Beauty is all around us. We want to protect the earth. That's why all our packaging is made from 100% recycled plastic, so that you can have more of the glamour and less of the waste. Introducing Laval. We are a makeup brand that prides ourselves on our sustainability and our inclusivity.
I really wish the best for you guys and have a great end of your senior year. I know this isn't probably what you expected, but I'm so proud of you for persevering.
That about wraps it up. Bye.
While you're at it, enjoy every little bit of Corvallis that you can, if you can.
That's all I've got for you guys. Congrats again, and let's get some more OSU design out in the world.
Woo!
It's fun. I think, you know, I'm out here doing it. I'm having a good time. I live in Texas now, so cool. I'm losing my train of thought, so I'm just gonna say, congratulations. Have a great, great life.
Hey, seniors. Deanne Garcia here, instructor in graphic design and the advisor for the Capstone Project. I'm a little sleepy this morning because yesterday I spent 16 hours stitching your videos together. So I hope you like the show. I have one last little piece of advice before I say goodbye to all of you, and that's just to stay optimistic. It's really hard right now in this environment, in the world we live in, to feel like there's a lot of hope. But it's going to be incredibly important for you to hang on to your optimism going forward. Being able to envision a better future is a prerequisite to being a designer. We are all relying on you to envision the future that we need to build together. So please just go out there and believe that something better is possible. Do your best. Take breaks. Don't work so hard. It's really not sustainable, I could tell you that much. It's really important for you to take care of yourselves. Enjoy this summer, get vaccinated, and keep in touch. Happy graduation.
Woot, 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 woot. Congratulations, class of 2021. I'll miss you, and I mean that. Okay, and one more thing, process.
Oh,